Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja, and today I want to talk about radon. We're getting a lot of questions about radon, and you know, it's something that should be paid attention to. It is got a lot of health issues. You want to make sure whether you're living in a state that has code for radon or whether it's required during a real estate transaction. So we're going to talk about some of that today, and stay tuned. Okay, so let's get right into it. We've got, what is radon, first of all? It is formed naturally in the ground. Radon is naturally occurring radioactive gas. Radon gas is inert, colorless, and odorless. In other words, you don't really know it's there unless you have it tested. Radon is naturally also in the atmosphere in trace amounts. Outdoor radon disperses rapidly and generally is not a health issue. So in other words, if you're outside, you're probably got some radon around you, but since it's diluted by all the air out there, it's not really considered a health risk. But if you're in your home and you have a concentration of radon built up, remember our houses are not designed to ventilate very well. When you build a commercial building, a lot of times code will allow you to bring fresh air in through the HVAC unit. Well, our houses, at least where we live, aren't designed to do that. So radon can be a serious problem, especially if you spend a lot of time in your basement or on the floors directly over an encapsulated crawl space. And of course, most radon exposure occurs inside your house or your school or your workplace. But again, schools and workplaces are typically ventilated through the HVAC system. So you might not have that much of an issue there, but if there is a concern, you may want to have it tested. So let's look at a couple of other things. Radon is obviously from the ground. Radioactive gas that has been found in homes all over the United States. There's no state that doesn't have it. It comes from natural breakdown of uranium inside the soil, rock and water that gets into the air you breathe. Well, here's another thing. Most people don't realize that you can have radon in your water. They actually make radon test kits for water as well. It typically moves up through the ground into the air above and into your home through cracks and other holes in your foundation. Now, here's a myth that I want to caution you about is a lot of times people will say that they have radon-proof vapor barrier for crawl spaces. And even if that is a possibility to keep radon out with a vapor barrier, if you overlap and it's not completely sealed or completely attached properly, radon gas will still find a way around the vapor barrier. So you got to be careful about that. Here's some, a lot of this stuff we pulled off of the EPA website and other websites, but radon is present in every state in the United States. The levels of the gas differ from the state to state, but it's particularly high in North Dakota and Iowa. So if you live in either one of those two states, you want to make sure you have your radon tested. The EPA actually gave a map of radon zones. Now keep in mind, I'm going to show you this map, but your neighborhood may be fine where the neighborhood next to you may have a radon problem. So even though you're showing high concentrations on this map in these areas, and Tennessee is down in this area, we got Nashville and even Johnson City, Tri-Cities, parts of Georgia and Alabama have high concentrations of radon. But you find it a lot in these areas as well, even up into New England and different places like that. So make sure that you check your state if you're concerned about radon. So how do I know if I have radon? You basically have to test for it. You can't smell it, can't see it, can't touch it. Obviously, it's in a gas form, so you want to make sure you test for it. There are a couple of different ways to do so. There are DIY kits. The state of Tennessee actually gives a free DIY kit. If you contact the state, there's a radon. If you just type in Tennessee radon free test kit on Google or Yahoo or Bing or whatever it is you're using, it should be able to pull up who you contact for that. As a matter of fact, just left a house today with a family that just got the free test kit. Now that is a kit that you take apart and you set. It's got good instructions. You set in a part of the house for I think 48 hours, and then you seal up the kit and send it off to the lab. All right, now if your state doesn't offer a free test kit, you can go to our DIY store and get a similar kit on our DIY store, or you can get the continuous monitoring. If you've got a basement or a part of the house where you're in a high radon level, you can set up these continuing monitoring devices that'll show and track radon throughout the day. If you got your windows closed, it's going to be more concentrated than when they're open, different things like that. And of course, you can pay a home inspector or somebody to come in and do a professional test if you want to do that as well. Here are what the kits look like. So this is the kit that we have on our website here, as well as the continuing monitoring system. These are both available on our DIY store, diy.crawlspaceninja.com, if you want to continuously monitor your radon or just test your facility one time. So they estimate that 1 out of 15 homes has radon according to the EPA. So if you want to know how many homes have it, there's your stat. So anyway, it's a good, good thing to test. We tested our house, made sure if we had basement or if we have a basement part of our house that we wanted to make sure we didn't have radon in. So it's a good thing to test. Keep in mind too, if you have an open crawl space, a ventilated crawl space, you're less likely to have radon versus you pay someone to encapsulate the crawl space, which is why we talk about active ventilation system in a crawl space, which no contractors seem to know anything about. The EPA requirement is 1 CFM for every 50 square feet of crawl space. So if you are closing your crawl space, doing it yourself, make sure you get that Lamanco PCV1 fan to help keep that soil gases blown out of the crawl space. And of course, Crawl Space Ninja makes that part of our packages when you have us do it. So what states require radon testing? There's actually 29 states that require disclosure of radon hazards upon the sale of a house. And I've put a link down here if you want to pause this and kind of type this in. It was a lot of states to mention, but in other words, during the sale of a house, they recommend a disclosure or even a test to show that you don't have radon. Now, Tennessee don't require it, but highly recommend it. So pay for that radon test kit if you have to. California, Illinois, Maryland, Minnesota, and Oregon require all new homes be built following radon-resistant new construction standards. Tennessee requires a pipe installed for radon, but they don't require the fan to be hooked up. That is dumb, okay? So the builder has to pipe it, but no one requires the fan to be installed, okay? Anyway, I don't know. New Jersey, Virginia, and Washington requires RRNC to new housing in radon areas also, and then Florida, Maine, and Rhode Island have voluntary, okay? So anyway, that's what we're looking at. Then we move on. Is radon a health risk? Now, this is probably the most important part of the whole presentation, is that according to the CDC, radon gets trapped in your lungs and over time can create a problem, even leading to lung cancer. It is the number two cause of lung cancer in America. And from what I understand, the number one cause of lung cancer among non-smokers, okay? So here are a couple of the states that require a person to have a radon license if you're going to hire somebody. As you can see, Tennessee is not one of those states. We do not do any radon mitigation in basements, but we will do radon mitigation as part of a crawl space encapsulation. A lot of people don't know how to do it. So we go by the EPA guidelines of overlapping and taping. And just because the state doesn't require a license for radon doesn't mean they get to not do it correctly. There's still EPA guidelines. You got to overlap and tape 12 inches, use polyurethane caulk, attach it to the walls, all this stuff, put a sub membrane radon mitigation system under the vapor barrier, so whenever it's turned on, it almost looks like your cheeks are sucked in. The plastic should suck down to the ground. That's what a radon mitigation system is. All right, but these states are the ones that require a contractor to be licensed. All right, smoking makes radon even more dangerous. We all know that smoking is hazardous to your health, but if you are a smoker, you're 10 times more likely to develop lung cancer if you have a house full of radon as well. So please, please, first of all, please stop smoking. I used to smoke. I get it. It's addictive. It's hard to quit. Keep trying. You can do it. All right. So anyway, all right, in summary, any home can have radon, okay? Any home. Oh, by the way, the level is 4 picocuries per liter or higher, okay? So if your test is 4 picocuries per liter or higher, the EPA says get radon mitigation done, okay? What they really say, though, is you want it under 2. Now, it's not a requirement to get under 2 because it's really difficult to get radon picocuries under 2 per liter, okay? Especially if you have a basement. Basements are actually a little bit more difficult to mitigate radon, in my opinion, than crawl spaces are, because when they pour the slab, you got a lot of cracks and things in the slab you got to deal with. Also, that's why it's important to test your house. And they also recommend you test your house every 2 years, even after you install the radon mitigation system. You should still test it every 2 years, which is why I like the continual radon test, not the open and send to the lab test, because the continual test is a little bit more expensive, but it's on a continual basis and it'll monitor your house all the time. If you find that radon levels are high with a standard test, a DIY test kit, they recommend you take a second test, and that you might even want to do it at night. So for example, if you do the first test kit when it's raining outside during the day, you set it up, you want to let it run for, I think it's 48 hours, depends on the test. Do it maybe when it's dry outside, and see no rain or whatever, if you can see the forecast, and see if the radon levels are higher, or maybe do it in the fall and then do it again in the winter, you know, different things like that, that you could check the picocurie levels and make sure they're consistent high all the time. And finally, like I said before, the EPA says the lower the better. So the lower you can get that radon out of your house, the better. Just like, you know, a little bit of skunk smell is still skunk smell, right? You want to get it all out. So anyway, if you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with us on our Ask a Ninja. And my name is Michael Church. Hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later. Thank you.